guys like yourself are going to start selling your GTOs and that, start going back into the stock and making more money. Then the cars, I think, will level off, maybe drop a few pennies. They'll never take a dump, though, because there's only so many of these out and everybody wants them.
Shelby GT500 with Carroll Shelby sitting in it.
I saw
it. Yeah.
Well, I saw something. It looked similar. It was a beefed up 05.
40-year anniversary. We're going to be... It says GT500 right on it. But it's very similar to this. It's going to be a 67. I'm going to try. But what I want to do is, after they're all done with it, I'm going to do 07, so that would be nice to get them to try it.
That'd be a fair trade.
It'd be a great marriage, wouldn't it? For sure.
It's just like I saw a Barrett this last year. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Except, the last 4 years.
Yeah.
The car sold for $500,000. Both together.
Yeah.
But, we've gotten two Batmobiles now. The first
originals?
The originals? You got the
original.
You got the 1989, 1990. Oh, okay. Then we got the Val Kilmer Batmobile. Mm-hmm. Now we'll film your Batmobile. Now we've got three. Now we got one more to go, which is the one that
franchised with him. We bought all his cars. Well, you've seen a lot of them.
Oh, yeah, they are.
Yeah.
But
we get yours, that would have to be three. And then we'll get you a little piece on
be sure and get that scoop in the back that doesn't have any Shelby letters on it, which is a one-off thing. You don't see that ever. Did you get that picture there right above you too? This, you know what I mean, just from here down, all right? Gauges, people want to see the gauges, the steering wheels, wood, you know, maybe that roll bar, you know, that kind of stuff. custom signatures too on their hood. And posters. Engine bay. The countdown continues. My gloves are on. I am here with the second rarest muscle car in the world. My hands are on it now. And here she is, the 1967 Shelby GT500. Now you say, now wait a minute, Rick. What's so special about a Shelby GT500? Well, let's take a closer look. EXP500. Now, what in the world is an EXP500? I'll tell you right now. It was a one-off car, one, made, and here it is right here. It's got no top. 67 Shelby, think about it. How many 67 Shelby GT500s have you seen? Convertible, none. That's why, because it is here, and the owner of this fabulous car is with me right now, Mr. Greg Grahams of the Volo Auto Museum. Mr. Grahams, thank you very much for allowing us to come in and see this spectacular automobile.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you were able to come out here and enjoy the car.
I don't think this car has ever been seen recently, anyway, on TV. I've never seen it before.
Well, the car has never been seen by the general public. Ford's policy on all their experimental cars are supposed to be crushed. Back in 1967, this car was built for Carroll Shelby, by Carroll Shelby, and it is the only 68 big block built by Shelby. Think about it. In 68, they were built in Detroit.
Right.
So it's the only big block convertible ever built by Carroll Shelby.
And this was his personal driver.
This was his personal car. He loved the convertible. He drove it around. It's 428 dual quad, but it isn't automatic with air conditioning. Matter of fact, Mr. Shelby's been out here. He's driven the car. He loves the car. He signed it. We got a lot of documentation with him in it. But anyway, the car in 1968 went back to Detroit, and they redisguised it as a 68. They hung a 68 front end on there and the hood, changed the interior, and that's what was a mystery to us. Someone purchased this car in 1969, and the car has been underground since 1969 until we discovered it 5 years ago. It was through a divorce we were able to purchase this car. The mystery was the 68 parts on there. We knew from Ford and everything that it was the only one ever built. Ford verified that. The mystery was the 68. Well, we found out they rehung 68. They were using it as a show car. Actually, it was, I guess you could say it was a prototype 68 also, but they're using it for photography. And then when the car was sold as a used car with a 68 front end. We were able to purchase the car, and then through Carroll Shelby, we got all the information on it. And through 4 years of research, we were able to get the car exactly the way it was when Carroll Shelby built it in 1967. And no one has seen this car. There is no pictures in any magazines or anything of the car because they weren't going to use it. Carroll was actually using it as his own personal driver.
And you have, for all you skeptics out there thinking this is some kind of kit thing, you have full documentation from the Ford Motor Company and Carroll Shelby.
From Carroll Shelby Ford Motor Company, we have every speck of documentation. It's 100% documented. We got pictures with Carroll Shelby. We have renders drawings of the car when it was first built. Carroll's been out here. Matter of fact, Carroll Shelby's going to be out here next year in June. He's going to be out here again for another Shelby show. So,
well, Greg, I can't tell you how thankful that I am, and I'm sure my audience is, for you allowing us to see this wonderful car. It is a one of a kind. I hope it never sells, because it really belongs in a museum. Thank you very much again for your time, and hope that we'll see you again soon. That's Volo Auto Museum at volo.com on the web.
Pretty grand for it.
That's great. What we'll do is we'll do about a, say, a 10, 15 second blurb on each car. You know, just give us a little, you know, our shop spotlight this week. We're at the Volo Auto Museum in Volo, Illinois, at volocars.com.
I'll show you the other building.
Let's get, how about these five or six right in this area? Say, maybe it's Torino. Or that's a Cobra GT. There's a whole Hurst old. We got to get that one. KR500 right there. Looks like it is anyway.
Right.
Or a 350. Yeah, convertible. Oh, boy.
Phew. Big black case car. These are larger. There are some museums that are larger. There is no one in the. Yeah, we have a lot of them for sale. Sold,
wow.
You know, they're just a lot of moving cars.
Right. All right, John, let's do that. We'll start right here. I'll tell you what,
we'll get these two out of the aisle, right?
No, let's leave them. We'll sell them big too. I said those clones are selling big too, so doesn't matter. Absolutely. Okay. Our shop spotlight this week is in Volo, Illinois. It's at the Volo Auto Museum, volocars.com. I got Mr. Greg Grams right here. He's going to take us through the several warehouses. Greg, let's don't waste any time. Let's go right through it. Let's see. We got, looks like a 69, what is that, 427?
Camaro there for $40,000.
All right. We've got, looks like a 66 GT.
66 Mustang Shelby convertible. Of course, you know, they only made six of them. This is a clone. It's only $30,000.
Check this out here. This is that going on 62nd. So it's white and black.
Yeah, this is the new one. We just got this car. It's a GT500 E-Series. That's the going on 60 seconds.
Yeah, you got it. Right behind me here, we've got a 1969, like a Ford convertible.
Yeah, Mustang for only 19.9.
Beautiful looking car, though. 69 Chevelle.
Yeah, this one right here is a 69 Chevelle Super Sport.
SS396.
Yep, 68, I'm sorry.
Behind me here, right here, 65 Mustang?
65 Mustang, two-door hardtop.
Two-door hardtop, it's got the console automatic. Right here we got a
convertible. This one here just
yeah
in. This one's going for $25,000.
This also a 66.
Yes, that is a 66, just came in. Most of the cars in here are cars that just came in. We average about 70 new cars a month. So
390 big block 4 Torino GT convertible.
GT, yes, 390, 360 horse. And that's only $25,000.
That car got a lot of grunt in it.
Yep.
Let's come right over here. We got a newer muscle, which is an 80, what? No, 76.
Yeah. Well, this is the pace car.
Oh, 78.
Yep, for $15,000.
Let's come back here. I've got a, what, a Stingray?
Yeah, I believe this is 69, 60. 69 Corvette Coupe for $17,000.
That's a good price on that. Uh-oh, Shelby.
No, this is this would have been the 68. This is the first Shelby convertible built. That's $200,000.
What is the, this got the 428.
428 is a GT500 KR convertible.
KR meaning king of the road, got the bigger motor in it.
Yes, it does.
Okay, and finally right back here for a beautiful convertible Vette. I love this car, 69.
Yes, 41,000 actual miles on it, 350, and that one's going for $38,000.
Good looking car. And how about the 18 van? What's happening with it?
Van, that's one of the from the movie there. That one there is only going for $20,000.
Volocars.com. We're going on to the warehouse number 205. VoloCars.com, warehouse number two. Here we go, Greg. What do we got? Right, first off, 69 Camaro.
Mine Camaro, Z28, $27,000. This one here is a 350 going for $32,000. That's an original Indy Pace car. That's one of the original 396s documented.
And we got a 66...
66 Mustang convertible going for $25,000.
Right here is Super Sport.
Yeah, this is kind of rare. This is purple. Most people haven't seen one, but yeah, that's
an original color.
That's an original color documented. That one's going for $40,000.
Gorgeous 396 SS.
69 SS 396, all matching numbers.
You got a 70 GTO Judge?
This is the Judge, 69 Ram Air Judge, all matching numbers, all correct original.
Dodge Challenger, is that right?
Yep, that's a small, that's a 340 Dodge Challenger, matching number, about $25,000.
And that's a good price, those cars keep going up. Mach 1 or 73?
Yeah, just a 73 convertible, that's only going for $23,000.
Good color scheme on that, though.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful car.
442, red and white stripes.
Yeah, white interior, beautiful car, original car, $34,000.
Good price on that. Another Camaro Z28, 69?
Yeah, 69 Camaro Z28. Those are very hot right now. That's probably the hottest car in the market.
Another Plum Crazy 383.
See, all matching numbered car, original motor, everything for $32,000.
A 340 Barracuda with dog dish rim.
Yeah, there you go. Now, there's a bargain of the century there. Four speed, and I believe that's going for around 19 grand.
A beautiful 68 Camaro.
Yep. Big block, all matching numbered, and that's going for $46,000.
That's a gorgeous car. And then we got behind you another convertible GTO, 65.
Yeah, there's another hot car. We have a lot of GTOs over here, but GTO is very hot in the market right now.
Boy, that's a gorgeous looking car. And then you got another Judge.
That's not a Judge. That's a Judge clone. But his original 455 Ram Air, and that's just a great driving car.
Now, behind me here, you've got the Fast and Furious Super Yanko Camaro.
Actually, we have almost all the cars from the Fast and Furious 2 and from the first movie. We have them all. A lot of them are for sale. Some are just display. This one is for sale.
And how much? I'm looking at a price. I can't believe it.
That's a 69 Camaro documented from the Too Fast, Too Furious for $29,000.
$29,000 for the original Too Fast and Furious.
Yes, it's not an original Yanko, but it's built by Year One. It's from the movie, yeah, only 29 grand.
Man, that's a heck of, I love that. And then you've got Arnold. Look at that.
Schwarzenegger, yeah, that one we're keeping there. That was the one they used in Terminator 3.
Okay, we're off to warehouse number three. Is that car for sale?
No.
Original 1967. The original car from Gone in 60 Seconds. Not for sale unless, you know, you want to come out with maybe a million or so. I don't know. I'm just talking. I don't even know what I'm talking about. You've got the Blues Brothers car right over there. I don't think it's for sale, is it, Greg?
No, that's not for sale. It's just on display here.
All right. We got now here a Le Mans.
Yeah, this is just in a Le Mans, not a GTO.
Beautiful color scheme, though.
Probably the only one that wasn't made into a GTO yet.
Is that a 70 Camaro?
70 Camaro, yeah. Big block, I believe.
All right, here we've got a yellow, what does this say, Chevelle?
One of 199. No, this is a Torino 429, 370 horse.
This car got a lot of grunt.
Yeah, here's a beautiful car. Body off, restored, 65 Chevelle.
327.
Yep, all built, air conditioning and all.
You got, now on the far corner over there, John, if we can get way over there, it looks like you've got another convertible.
Convertible, yeah, 66, and I believe that's going for around 29,000. Next to it, we got a Judge convertible over here.
And then you got another Mustang here.
Mach 1, 351 over here, a white one.
Right here, we've got a Charger 500.
Beautiful car, yeah, this documented, highly optioned, and it's all original, $44,000.
And you got a good price on that.
Yes, we do.
All right, right behind me here, we've got another 65 Mustang.
65 Mustang convertible. As you can tell, we got a lot of them. They're hot.
And a gorgeous trimmed. You see, notice that trim on that 67 Fastback.
That's a 390. 68 Fastback. Yeah, it was before the Mach 1s. Now that's a 390.
But look,
rare car.
Look at the trim, though, around the trunk lid and the fender wells. That's rare on those cars.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a pretty rare car.
That makes it pretty. All right, behind me here, another, what do we got here, 66?
Yep, it's a 66 Mustang Fastback. Those are pretty much in demand now. A lot of people like those.
With the red pinstriping on those tires.
Still very affordable cars, the Mustangs.
Chevelle convertible SS.
Yep, this is a Chevelle big block convertible, 396, all matching, 43,000.
Next to that, another Chevelle.
Big block Chevelle for 35,000, yes.
That's still a good price on that car. Right here, another GTO, I believe.
GTO, yeah, 65. Again, they're pretty hot GTOs. We're looking for them.
Gorgeous color on this, too, and a matching interior.
Yep.
And is that another, no, that's the SS Chevelle.
69 Chevelle, yeah, 69 over there.
And then finally behind me here, we've got a, oh, the OTA.
Yeah, 69 Pontiac Trans Am, all documented, just only a few miles on it, 19 grand.
Let me ask you about one other car. I don't think it's for sale. Let's look at it anyway, unless you got big dollar right here.
Yeah, Hemi convertible. This is the 1970 CUDA convertible. It's just on display over here at the museum. It's not for sale, though.
Unless you got big dollar.
Right.
Every time you say Hemi, price goes up.
Goes up. Yes, it did.
Well, there you have it. The VoloCars.com at the Volo Auto Museum. Mr. Greg Grams, the owner here. Greg, thanks again for your time.
Thank you.
I said, you got a 67 GT500 convertible. I said, my understanding wasn't. And the guy went into it. Well, yeah, it was, you know, sort of him hauled. I said, how much are you asking for a car's no price? He said, we'll take.
That's my son.
I don't think it was that much documentation.
There was a few modifications we had to change, as Carol said, because we had a flat. Saddam's right-hand man. He was blown up and killed. We got his original uniform with the medals, the hat, and everything. Of course, he's dead now. We got a lot of personal belongings out of Saddam's, one of his homes. We have his uncut money. We have, God, there's so much stuff. This is our stuff. This is what we're using on them. This Katusha missile. They're still using these in Afghanistan and Iraq. Piece like this, we just turned down $100,000 on it. Civilians can't own them. There's only three of them in the United States, and I own one.
Rocket launcher.
Yeah, it's a Katusha rocket launcher. And there's the rocket. Everything, of course, is demilitarized. The Fed's been through. Everything is legal. Nothing is operable. Yeah, when this is all done in the cases here, there's the money. That's uncut money out of his vault.
An Iraqi flag.
We got a whole lot of stuff on that. And there again, we're the only museum with
him.
You know what we got? We got tons of stuff in here. You have to see it all.
Well, this is fascinating. Absolutely fascinating.
Like I said, for Halloween, it's a little haunted.
Yeah.
And now, like the weekend now, this will be steep. We're very proud about the weekends. And there will actually be a guy sitting in here.
Oh, right.
Yeah, it's going to be very spooky. Yeah. Oh, yeah. They come down, you know, in the sand.
Yeah.
We're out there.
Sure.
And then these, the whole thing turns up and down. And inside, there's all the radios, and it's got night vision and everything. So you can lock on the missile to whatever you want to shoot, and it's guided right to it.
Wow.
Army aircraft again. This one was retrofitted. They used to lock missiles right onto these and blow these out in Vietnam. And this was one of the last ones where they shot the exhaust up so there was no more heat. And the heat was diverted, so this was going to lock on to this one.
That is wild. I've never seen one up close like
that. That one's from the movie MASH. I got the world's largest monster truck. I can outpull Bigfoot. Bigfoot camera first year monster that was built. That's very top heavy, but extremely heavy and extreme a lot of torque. It's not like the new ones that fly over the cars.
I bet that thing makes a racket.
It's loud. But this thing here, when the new ones now, they're fiberglass bodies. They fly over the cars. This is one of the first ones in Bigfoot. But this pulled down a two-story house, 40 railroad cars, and pulled three monster trucks. Got so much torque.
Wow.
So the whole thing hydraulically lifts up, you know, before you crush the cars, the whole thing. We have it all the way down to fit in here.
I bet this thing weighs a ton.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Two semis when I bought it. One semi for the...
I saw the two gentlemen who...
Don't see too many of those around.
Fried.
The other day, a guy asked, he says, would you be interested in a gas chamber? And I thought he was serious. I'm going, yeah. And he says, I'm just joking. You got an electric chamber. He says, you got to be crazy.
Wow.
Yeah. That's unbelievable.
Now these are all original. Even the side pipes came original on that car.
That's the original window sticker, and they're listed on there.
Wow. Isn't that something? This is a great collection to have. Somebody should really jump on this, you know? This could be a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Yeah. Really could. Literally. Could
well, we were thinking between these, we've got a Z11, a Z16, and a ZL1. If you had the right combination of money, you could have one of the top Chevy collections in the world.
I mean, just to get one.
Yeah, money's good.
Money is good. He probably bought them for 50, 49, 34, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. He probably doesn't have 100 grand in all of
them. Probably not.
Was Yenko in Pennsylvania?
Yes.
These are all real ones. All yes. Real 427 Yankees.
Yep.
They've been going for north of a quarter of a million, haven't they?
Yeah, it depends on condition, but yeah, they can go for that or more.
Well, I mean, these are really high quality ones. They're
yes.
Tell me about Roger's Corvettes. He's got that ZL1.
Yeah,
I'm going to contact him and see if I can get that filmed. He's got it right on his website. I found his website.
Mm-hmm. There are only two.
Only two.
There is one that's purported to be the other one with no documentation.
Okay. So it's for all practical purposes. Mm-hmm. That's the one thing, too, about those ZL. Get all you need, John. I'm going to pop off all the hoods and everything. Unless you want to do it individually, you know, just let me know. Back and forth, right and left. Yeah. You need your top light on?
No.
Okay. I'll follow the stripes and go to the windshield. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You see them Zebra 69? Yanko. Looks good. I know that's gonna look sharp. Get that rear end too, remember? Beautiful. Perfect. No hood release. What a great collection.
It's nice, isn't it?
Oh. This piece 3 weeks ago at Rand Wharton.
New York?
Yeah. 1971 Hemi Cuda convertible. These cars here, if they were $2 million, look what you're getting.
That's what I've been telling
for
you.
For $2 million. Yeah. And these cars, as time goes on, is rarer and rarer. That Hemi Cuda, in my opinion, is bubbled up.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
These cars here are high-end, I understand, but in the low run.
I was going to say, Hemi cars weren't very good in a quarter mile.
Yeah,
you didn't want to race them for a mile.
That 440 car, from my understanding, of course, we all know, but these little cars here are so light, bang! You know what I mean?
High revving cars, you know?
And the 67, oh. I've only seen one other one. One, but it wasn't a super sport.
No,
it had the exposed headlights, no side pipes. It was green. You know what I mean? But the other green one I saw.
Yeah, this one's the RSSS package.
Unbelievable. This right here, I know what the price of this one is. This one here, that's a $250,000 automobile. Yeah. It got to be.
I think that Nova in the corner is twice that. Never ever built.
Cars thinking the timing is right, unload them now.
Yeah.
Thinking that the.
Well, I think he's had them for a while. And it's
probably got less than 100,000 in them.
I think it's like anything else. You spend time going after them.
Connoisseur, you know, it won't dull them.
I'd love to see them all go together.
Me too. But I'm glad we were able to catch them because as I editing crew and John and everyone else, a lot of times these cars will go to collector and they'll put them away. And they won't ever be seen again. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what will happen, and that's why I'm so appreciative that we're able to get in here and get them.
This is a rare opportunity to see all of these.
That's for sure.
Together.
I've never heard of ever. But
well,
now,
this guy's been flying below the radar screen for a long time.
Now my audience will be able to really appreciate it. You know, they'll never be able to buy the car, but you know, they'll be able to see it now. We'll document it. Here they are for all time. Shows now.
Okay.
You know, and so we have four segments in one show, and that's the end. That's the last segment, you know, in the show. And we're going to have this car here as car number 5 or 6 or something like that. I don't remember.
Okay.
It doesn't matter. Because we do a bunch of voiceover afterwards. Anyway,
sure. You know. What else do you have on your list?
Well, the number one car is the Al Maynard 68 Z28 convertible.
Okay,
but
sure.
It was a production car. But it was a one-off car, and now it's been documented, so now it's one. It's number two.
Okay.
The number three car we haven't gotten yet is a 69 Z01 Corvette. Let's get this placard on this one too. something about this.
Body work on it.
I think the motor's been gone through. If I had to guess, it just looks freshly painted.
Maybe it's even more valuable the way it's in front.
It is. That's why nobody's done anything with it. And this is one of the rare ones that put a Camaro spoiler on too.
Yes.
That was an option. Boy, I'll tell you, it looks like hell, but that's the way the car came.
This is a much heavier car too.
Yeah. My partner's got.
Bow tie guys, you had better sit down for this one. I got something that is going to blow your mind. Okay, now we all know what Yanko was, right? Don Yanko, back in the 60s, putting the 427 Rat motor in the Camaro and the Nova and the Chevelle. Now, if you were to see a Yanko in an auction, one or one for sale, it would be an incredible thing to see. However, how many times have you seen all five of them together at an auction at Meekum's for sale in one lot at the same time? Gentlemen, feast your eyes on a miracle. I think I could do better. 32 miles. 32 miles. Let's go. 32 miles. Welcome back to Muscle Car Madness. What do you think of when I say the word Yanko? For all you bow tie guys, you had better sit down for this one. I have got something that is going to blow your mind. Don Yanko, back in the 60s, we all know, he put the 427 motor in the Camaro, the Chevelle, and the Nova, right? We know that. And to see a Yanko car, a real Yanko car now, would be a very, very special treat if it was for sale at an auction or whatever. However, at Muscle Car Madness, I am going to deliver to you today five Yankos in the same auction at the same time. 67, 68, 69, 69 Chevelle, and 69 Nova. Gentlemen, enjoy. All you bow tie guys, you better have a seat because I'm about to blow your mind. When you think of the word Yanko, what's the first thing to come to your mind, right? 427 power and Don Yanko's Chevrolet dealership up in Pennsylvania back in the 60s. If you were to see a Yanko for sale today, you're talking about a quarter of a million dollar automobile, right? And if you were to see one, it would be a very special event. So what are the odds of seeing all five production original Yankos at one time? Impossible? Not anymore. Welcome to Yanko Heaven, gentlemen.
Seats and come up and look at this wherever, ladies and gentlemen. F 15 feature car number 54 to boot. They wear the most common and desirable color. Has documentation to build shades on board.
What do you got? Okay, you got 42, down 43. High 42, down 43.
Put intro, and then we're out of here with this car.
High 43, down 4, double down 4, double down 4. High 43, down 4, anybody else? High 43, down 4, double down 4, double down 4, $44,000. 43, down 44. High 43, down 4, double down 4, double down 3, 4. High 43, down 4, 4 down 4, double down 4, 43 cent down over here, down 44. High 43, down 4. High 43, down 4.
We'll have to get them in between.
High 43, down 4. Over here. Over here. Over here. Okay, over here. 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 Over
here. 70
model. Down 22, down 23.
24 down 5
you're out now. I had 24 5 7 and a half
over ninth rarest most car in the world, Charger Hemi. It's time to go rare, and here we go. Charger
six speed
Hemi Daytona. It's time to go rare, and here we go with the Charger. Okay. Hemi. Okay. Daytona. Woo! Jane inside, that's for sure. We'll start over here, as a matter of fact. ''69 Plymouth GTX. What in the world makes this car so rare? One of five built, and I'm going to show you what makes it so rare. Follow me. Plymouth GTX, you see this, convertible, but I'm not through. You ready? What makes a Plymouth GTX qualify for the white glove rarest muscle cars in the world? I'm going to show you. Follow me. One of five made with no top. Okay, I understand that. However, one of five made with, you got it, the elephant, boom, 426 Hemi, 1969 Plymouth GTX. It's cut. The countdown continues, and I have got something that is going to take your hair off. A double whammy today on the rarest muscle cars in the world. The countdown continues, but today I've got a double whammy for you. The countdown continues on the rarest muscle cars in the world, but today I got a double whammy for you. Yanko 1969 Nova, one of six known to exist, certainly a rare car. However, stop. Shit, I got it. ...1967 Yanko Camaro. 1967 Yanko Camaro, one of seven known to exist, and 1969 Yanko Nova, one of six to exist, certainly rare. Son of a... ...1967 Yanko Camaro, one of seven known to exist. 1969 Yanko Nova, one of six to exist, certainly rank two of the rarest muscle cars in the world. Woo! And we got them right here on Muscle Car Madness.
Dollars, you want a bit? Last call. Once, twice.
And then saying that I think I know where the other one is. Stay tuned. Our special car this week. Our spotlight car this week features the world's rarest Hemi-powered car. Now, when I say that, what do you think of? Daytona, Superbird, Plymouth, maybe a Cuda? What if I was to tell you that the world's rarest Hemi in the world is in a Corvette? Yes, 1966 Dodge Coronet 426 Hemi, one of four made. Now, wait a minute. You're saying, what's so rare about that? Look at this. It's a four-door Hemi. Four-door. Only four were made. Two Euro cars and two American cars. This is one of the American cars made. Four-door with a 426 Hemi. Now, hang on. I think I know where the other one is. There's only two. Here's one. I know where the other one is, and I am going to get it for you. Only on Muscle Car Madness.
Great car.
Greatest sound in the world. That'll be an opening screenshot or something, you know, who knows. Get those three deuces there. GTO with three deuces.
And go around the, go past the pool and the clubhouse lounge. Here's the clubhouse lounge. Right on the other side, there's an ATM machine.
Pass. Okay, got it.
Close?
Yeah, you got to go through the hotel. Check, sound check. Welcome back to Muscle Car Madness. We're in St. Charles, Illinois, home of the MeekumsAuctions.com. It's happening here right now this weekend. A lot of cars, big money, something for everybody, and here we go. All right, that was 67, 427 to 390 horse.
400 horse. 427, 400 horse.
427, 400 horse. Closer to 25. Here it comes, 1967. You got the black.
1967.
427, 400 horse. You got it. Gorgeous car.
With air, complete restoration, completed in 2004. Fully documented, has a car seat paint sticker. Owner's manual, warranty.
This is a flawless automobile. It is here.
Engine has a trim plate and carburetors, power brakes, headrest, power steering.
It's got it all. Windows,
telescoping wheel, 400 horsepower, 427 engine, 67 Corvette.
Yes, sir. Here we go. White interior. White interior, headrest, four-speed. Let's get the interior. Full wood steering wheel, fully documented. About 105 now, it should go a little higher than that.
$105,000 on this car. 125, 105, anybody else? 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105,000, sir. 105,105. We're close.
Followed on the way out.
Close the car at 105. It's going to get closer to 130.
125. Takes 125 to buy. Close it there.
Okay, next car is the next car sold. Yeah. No reconditioning.
About 7.5. 11.2.5. 11.5. High 2.5. Got 11.2.5. Down 5 doing it. High 2.5. Pound it. 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 Down 7.5. Down 14. Russell takes 15,000. Takes 15,000.
But again, would you like to? Would you like the car?
All right, next car, number 128, 1957 Chevrolet Bel Air. Two-door hardtop, rust-free, with the numbers matching 283 four-barrel, power-packed V8. Engine was just completely rebuilt, balanced, and blueprinted by one of the best engine builders in Iowa. This 57 has power steering plus a vintage air conditioning system. Radio is auto, custom sound AM FM. Interior is brand new, along with the BF Goodrich wide white wall tires.
Okay, here we go. 57 model Chevy Bel Air. What are we going to get for it? $50,000. Anybody got 54? Anybody got 45? Get 45, 45. Start the bid.
Can we open the door?
Start the bid. 40. I'm at 40,000. I'm at 40. Now 40. Now 40. 40. Give me 35, Ron. I'm at 35. 35. 35. You want to get 30? I'm at 30,000. I'm at 30. Now 30. Now 30. 25. I'll take it. 27,5. I'm at 25,000. 27,5. Paul, now 30. I'm at 27,5. Now 30. Now 30. Now 27,5. Now 30,000. 30. Now 30. I'm at 27,5. Now 30. Now 30. Now 30. Now 27,5. Now 30,000. I'm at 30. Now 27,5. 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000, 30,000,
Let's see if we can find the winning bidder. If he's here, we'll try to get it, see if he wants to be on camera. If we can find him.
Last call, do you want a bid, sir? Number 34 to 5 for it. Anybody else?
Here we go.
Gonna close the bid again. $34,000. Gonna close the bid again. $34,000.
All right, next car, 1968 American Motors AMX. Extensive recent body off restoration of a California rust free car. Correct accent stripe, correct chrome wheels with red line tires, power windows, power steering, power brakes, power disc brakes, and air conditioning. 1968 AMX.
68 AMX. How much over here? Got air, there's air, there's air. What am I going to get for it? I'll buy California rust free car with air, power windows, power steering, power brakes.
Can we open the door?
What am I going to get for it? I might take a look at an infinite detail. What am I going to get for me? Number 45,000, 45, and then what am I going to get? Give me 40,000, start the bid, 40. Number 45, and then 40, give me $35,000 bid. Number 35, and then 35, 35, and then 35, 20, 20, 225. Number 20,000, 225, and then 20 bid, and 225. Number 20,000, 225, now 25,000. Number 20, 25 and 25,000. Number 22, 5 down 25,000. 25,000, 25. Number 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, 27,000, Unedited, they're down 29 pounds out of the car, has air, power options, loaded up car, Colin, 29,000, 28. 29.
Yeah, there were some cars in this auction that are real rare. And my show, we document very rare automobiles. Plus another segment, we do some auction action. You know, muscle car madness. We're filming it now. So we'll film it, then edit it, and put it out there. Probably next spring.
Well,
whoever wants to buy it. I don't care who buys it. Don't matter. Let's try to get some of that exhaust noise.
Now to the half, down to the day. Up and down, $9,000.
Feature car number 26, 1969 Camaro, totally restored. Very correct, performs excellent.
On the edge.
It's got X11 Z28 trim. Not original engine. It's a 302, 290 horsepower. M21 4-speed. 12-volt power, posi-traction, power steering, power disc brakes, factory tack engages. Correct 15x7 rally wheels. New Goodyear radials, spoilers, cowl hood.
On the edge.
Got a crowd hood.
Get some of that exhaust noise when he leaves. Okay.
All right, car number 132, 1967 Corvette convertible. Has only 33,000 actual miles. Numbers matching 327, 300 horsepower. Original transmission and rear end completely restored. Runs and drives great. Great high quality Corvette for any collector. A 1967.
Can we open your door?
Numbers matching 33,000 actual miles. 33,000 miles.
Okay, let's sell the car. Jerry, what did we get for it?
Thank you.
55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, 55,000, What'd he say? $17,000 down, $20,000 down, 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 $17,000 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 down
25. Feature car number 27, 1965. pony car. This little pony is refinished in its original color, Rangoon red. Although it has had a mechanical and cosmetic restoration, it does have actual mileage. Branded on the title at 29,000 miles. Also has an odometer statement from the previous owner. Cruise-O-Matic transmission, power steering, styled steel wheels, vinyl roof, dual red line tires. Owner selling the car to have 29,000 actual miles.
Okay, well, the stars of the show, what about to get on it? How high, what about to get on it here? 35,000. I'm at 35, I'm at 30. Start the start to bid. 30, 25, 20. Who will get 15? Somebody will. 15, 17, 5. 17, 5. 15,000, 17, 5. 15, 5. 17, 5. 15,000, 17, 5. 15,000, 17, 5. 15,000, 17, 5. 16, 17,000. Hop it down, 17, 8, 1, 2, 17,000. Did you get it? 16, 17, if you need her. How about 17,000, how about 17,000? 16,000, how about 17? How about 17, 17, 17,000, 17,000? 16,000, how about 17? How about 17, 17,000? I can't believe it.
Got respray for 16, I suppose, yeah.
Automatic power steering, style steel wheels, red line rubber. 16, 17. How about 17,000? How about 16,000, how about 17,000? 16. 16,500. Reserves off cars for sale. Reserves off cars for sale. 16. 17,000. How about 17? Do you want to bid down 17? 16,500. 16,500 down 16 bid to 5. How about 5 bid to 5 for? Said it drives perfect. The owner said the car drives perfect. 16. 16,500. Do you want to bid? Gotta go. Shut it down. Reserves off. 16,500. Do you want to bid? How about 5 bid to 5 for? Down 16,500 bid to 5.
Oh yeah. My name is John Provenzano.
You give us permission to use your image on film?
Yep.
Here at the Meekham Auction, we're in St. Charles, Illinois. I'm with the gentleman that just purchased that. It was a 65 Mustang. Had original miles about 21, 22,000 original miles.
29,000.
Like I had a respray, though.
Yeah, it might have had. Might have had. Night car, though.
You, I think, just about stole that car. You think about $14, $15,000?
Yeah, I think. Oh,
Was the price right?
No, I don't know. That car... hard to say. I mean, that car you bring it here tomorrow, I'll probably bring another $4,000 or $5,000.
What are you going to do with it?
Give it to my daughter.
You're a good man. I don't care what everyone else says. You're a good man. All right.
Thanks again. Muscle Car Madness.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jim Landis.
Number 28. 68 model.
And that's right, your floor manager can't help you. Here we go, we've got feature 2868 model GTO in the full Pontiac Historical Society information with it. You got the original build sheet in an excellent condition, photo documentation of all the numbers.
We're
on the
all
top.
Done. We're done.
A documented two owner with the title history, Oregon car since day one. Correct color combination, complete body on Presto with the original sheet metal. We've got floor pans, original truck pans.
That's your owner right there.
Absolutely gorgeous automobile with power steering. We've got weather touch. We've got AM radio in it, electric antenna, rally gauge cluster with clock, soft ray glass on it. Gorgeous automobile, duct, deluxe steering wheel. The list goes on and on. Let's sell a car.
And somebody get $65,000 here. You better get 65 in. You better get 5 here. You better get 60,000. You better get 60 in. You better get 50. Photo of all the casting numbers. Somebody get 50,000. You better get 50 bin. You better get 50. You better get 40. You better get 30. You better get 30. You better get 15. 20. All right, 15. You better get 20,000. You better get 17.5. Now 20,000. You better get 2.5. 22.5.
Can we open the door?
You better get 22.5. Now 5. $25,000 bin. You better get 25. All right, $22,500 bin. You better get 25,000. You better get 23. 24, 25, 26, $26,000 bid, you better get 7. All right, 26 and now, $27,000 bid, you better get $27,000, 28. All right, 27 bid, you better get $8,000, you better get $27,000, you better get $28,000. All right, 27 bid, you better get $28,000 bid, you better get $8,000, you better get $28,000. I'm only $27,000 bid. Anybody get $28,000? All right, $27,000, you better get $28,000 bid, you better get $7 bid, you better get $8,000, you better get $28,000. Anybody get $28,000 for it? All right, $27,000, you better get $28,000.
$28,000 bid. You better get $8,000. You better get $7,500. $27,500 bid. You better get $27,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get $27,500. $27,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get $5,000. Anybody else? $27,500. $27,000. $27,500. GTO with a build sheet. $27,500. Roll away, $27,000. Anybody get 27 and 5? I have 27,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get 5 here. You better get 5 here. You better get 27 and 5. Roll it. I have 27,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get 5 here. You better get 5 in. You better get 27,000. You better get 500. At 27,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get 5. Gonna close the bid at $27,000. Next car.
That's right. 66 model number 137. Gorgeous automobile. Real black car with a very rare silver interior. Original matching number engine in it, 427 cubic inch, 425 horsepower. Clean frame on it, original gearbox with 411 rear ratio and posi traction. Extreme rare color combination, a real high horsepower big block to boot. And we've got power windows, 4-speed manual transmission, 39,000 miles on an original drivetrain. Sell a car.
All right, how much? I'm going to pay for this car. Somebody give $150,000. You better give $150 bid. Give $100,000. Belongs to Raj down there. $100,000 bid. $100,000. You better give one bid. Give $100,000. You better give $100,000 bid. $100,000. Somebody give $100,000 bid. You better give one bid. You better get 25. 30, 30 bid. You better get 35. I have 30,000. You better get 30 bid. You better get 30,000. You better get $500 bid. You better get 30,000. You better get 35. I have $30,000 bid. You better get 35,000. You better get 5. 35. Yes?
Can we open your door?
Now 40. I have 35 in. You better get 40,000. You better get 40 in. You better get 35 dead. 40. I have 40,000. You better get 40 in. You better get 40. You better get 40. Go ahead. 40. I have 40,000. Now 45,000. You better get 45. I have 40 in. You better get 25. 42,5. 42,5. 40 dead. You better get 25. I have 40,000. You better get 42,5. I have 40,000. You better get 25. You better get 25. 41,2. What'd you find out? 42. 42,3. 3 in. You better get 3. You better get 3. You better get 43. 44. 44. You better get 45. 45. 45. 45. 45. 44. I have 44, you better get 45, bid me 5, 45, 45,000, you better get 45, 45,000, bid me 5, here, you better get 45, 45, 45, 50, 45, 46, 45, bid, you better get 46, 7, 47,000, you better get 8, 47, you better get 8,000, you better get 8, now 9, you're out, Bobby, 49, 48, you better get 49, I have 48, you better get 49,000, you better get 8, bid, you better get 9, here, you better get 49,000, you better get 8, bid, you better get 49, I have 48, you better get 49, Kevin's in, 48, now 49, bid, you better get 9, I have 48,000 bid, you better get 49, 85, now 9, 9 bid, you better get 9, at 49,000, you better get 9,5, 49,5, 49,5, 49,5, 50, $50,000 bid, you better get 51, at 51,000, you better get 1 bid, you better get 1, you better get 1, you better get 51, at 51,000 bid, you better get 1 bid, you better get $50,500. $50,500, now 1, 51, 51, 51, 5, 51, 5, 51, 5, 2, 52, 52, 52,000, you better get 5, 52, 5, 52, 5, and you better get 2, 5, here, you better get 52, 5, 52 is bid, you better get 2, 5, I have 52, you better get 2, 5, here, you better get 52, 5, 52, 5, 52, 5, 52 is bid, you better get $500 bid, you better get 5, 52, 2 and a half, now 5, 52, 5, 52, 2 and a half, you better get $500 bid, now 7 and a half, 50,000, 7 and a half, 52, 750, 52, 7 and a half, 53, 53 bin, you better get 3, you better get 3, you better get 2 and a half, 53, 2, 50 bin, you better get 53, $500 bin, you better get 5, 53, 5, 53, 750, 53, 750 bin, you better get 55, what? 55,000, is that what you said? Boy, I love that. 55,000 is bid, your man's out here now, 56, what do you want to do? 56,000, 55, 56, how about 55, 5, that's what he always likes to do, you want to get 55, 5? 55,5 started up and rolled away. 55,000, you better get 55,5. 55,000, you better get $500 bid. You better get 5 here. You better get $55,000 bid. You better get 55,5. I have 55,000, you better get 55,5. 55,000, you better get 55,5. Hold the car right there. You better get 55,5. 55's been 5. Now 56,000, you better get 56. Well, Terry, now we go for a ride. 56. 55,5 in, you better get 56,000. You better get 56. 55,5 in, you better get 56. Anybody else? 56,000. Bid me 56. 56,000 bid, you better get 56 here. Now 56,5. 56,5, 57,000, $57,000 bid, you better get 57, and now 5, 57,5, I have 57 bid, you better get $500 bid, you better get $60,000, now you're all out, $61,000, 60,000's bid, 61,000, I have 60,000, you better get 61,000, you better get 61, what's that mean, that you're all done? Well, he can't be, 61, 60,000, 61. I have 60,000. Put it on him. Put it on him. 61. 60,000. You better get 61. You're on TV, sir. The whole world's going to see you say no. 60,000. $61,000. 60,000. You better get $61,000 once. He said it's up to you.
Hey, don't ask him. They're chasing their heads the wrong way.
Yeah, what she said was, I do not want to take it home.
Yeah.
I believe that's what I saw when I saw it. What's this?
That means
don't come home with the car. That's what that meant, right? 60,000 is bid. 61,000. $60,000. You better get $60,000. Well, how much does it take, ma'am? How much have we got to get so that he can sell his car? How much? You go ahead and pick the number, ma'am. How much do we have to get? How much?
It's up to him.
It's up to him?
That means
she said it's up to you. Do what you want. You're going to do it anyway.
So Jimmy just helped you out quite a little bit until you get home.
$60,000. $61,000. What are we doing?
Dana's got to come back. We're having
Oh, my. Ma'am, can we sell it for 60? Can we sell it for 65,000? All right, that's enough of that.
That's enough. Go. Get it out. Go.
Take it out.
Let's go.
Now you ruined it for everybody. Take it outside.
Go.
Take one walk around it, too.
1953 must have been an absolutely unbelievable year to be a General Motors employee. Think about that. The first year of the Corvette. Now, story went that the number one car and the number two car did not pass General Motors inspection, but the number three car did pass. And right now, I'm going to bring to you the rarest Corvette in the world. The number three car, we caught it earlier this year at the Rand Workman Auction up in New York. Enjoy it. 1953 Vette, the 003 Vette from General Motors. Cut that. Do that again. Can you imagine what it must have been like in 1953, working for General Motors, the first Corvettes rolling off the line. What an exciting time for American muscle. However, the story went that the first two Corvettes, 001 and 002, did not pass General Motors inspections. I don't know why, but they didn't. But number three car did pass inspections. It survived. And we're going to bring it to you right now, the 1953 003 Vette at Rand Workman Auction we saw earlier this year in New York. Enjoy. It must have been an exciting time to work for General Motors in 1953. Think about it. It must have been an incredible time to work for General Motors in 1953. Stop. Can you imagine working for General Motors in 1953 when the first Corvettes came down the line? Well, it may not have been so great because it was rumored that the first two cars failed to pass the General Motors inspection. However, the number three car did pass inspection. The oldest Corvette in the world, we found it at Rand Workman up in New York earlier this year, and I'm gonna bring it to you right now. All right. Was that a sound problem? Yeah. Yeah, coming out of my mouth. Can you imagine what it... All right, try it again. Can you imagine what it must have been like to work for General Motors in 1953? The Corvettes are coming down the line, but it was rumored the first and second vet did not pass General Motors' strict inspections, but the third car did pass. So, without any further ado, we found the car at Rand Workman this year earlier in New York. Enjoy the world's oldest Corvette. Let me know when you're ready. It must have been an unbelievable situation to work. Can you imagine what it must have been like to work for General Motors in 1953, the first vets coming down the line? But it was rumored that the first two vets could not pass General Motors' strict inspections. However, the number three car did pass, it survived, and we found it for you up at the Rand Workman Auction in New York earlier this year. So, without any further ado, the world's oldest Corvette here on Muscle Car Madness. Can you imagine what it must have been like in 1953 when the first Corvettes were coming down the assembly line at General Motors? The rumor was that the first two vets could not pass. What was the problem there? All right.
Thank you for your support this year. All right,
let me know. Can you imagine? All right. Can you imagine what it must have felt like in 1953 when those first vets coming down the line at General Motors? Now, the rumor was that the first two vets, 001 and 002, could not pass inspection, but the number three car, it did pass inspection, and we found it for you up at the Rand Workman Auction in New York. So I want you to enjoy the world's oldest Corvette here at Muscle Car Madness. Remember, we got this is 30 seconds on this vehicle. Let's document now. Arnie? Arno.
Right.
I'm gonna look down at Arno.
Okay.
Arno Zine. Let's take a walk down history lane of Corvette. 1953 was the beginning. This is the end of C1, first body style of Corvette. And with me here is Mr. Arno Zine. Arno, tell me about this 62 vet.
This 1962 vet we found in 1988. It took us 4 years to restore it. It's a 62 fuel injected, number 4613. This car originally cost around $4,000 in 1962. It costs about 25 times that right now.
Would you take $4,000 for it today?
I don't think so. We'd take $4,000 for the steering wheel.
1962, end of the first year C1 vet. For the description. The end of the first year body style started right here. This was the end. The start over. Shit, that sucked. That wasn't the end of the first year. That didn't make any sense. All right. This was the end of the C1 body style, the first generation vet. Okay, here we go. the end of the C1.
The end of the C1.
End of the C1 body style.
The end of the C1